Hi everyone, welcome to our online class. In last class, we started the topic test of significance for single mean. Test of significance for single mean, right? I gave the introduction for test of significance for single mean and we started, we solved one problem, right? Now, see the next problem in this topic. What is saying here? A sample of 400 items taken from your population whose standard deviation is 10. A sample of how many items it took it here? It took it as 400 items. A sample of 400 items taken from a population whose standard deviation is 10. And the mean of the sample is how much? 40. Then what is asking? Test whether the sample has come from a population with the mean 38. Actually, that population mean is how much? 38. Then what is asking? Whether this sample, this 400 items collected from this population or not, he is asking. Correct? What is the population? Population is a what? Large. Sample is what? We are collecting some sample. How many items we took it? We took it as 400 items. Now, also find here 95% confidence interval, he is asking. Correct? So, how to solve this one? First of all, write down the given data, what data he gave here. So, the first of all, what he gave here, sample size. See here, solution, sample size. What is sample size? How many items he took it, He took it as 400 items. Sample size n is equal to 400. Then what is sample mean? Sample mean is denoted by x bar. Is how much sample mean is 40. Sample mean is 40. Then standard deviation. Standard deviation sigma, how much it is? Standard deviation sigma is how much? 10. Correct? Standard deviation sigma he gave here 10. Now population mean how much? Population mean mu is equal to how much it is? 38. Population mean mu is equal to 38, correct? This is the data he gave in the problem. Now, what we have to do? We have to write that our 5 steps. What are the 5 steps? What is the step 1? Step 1 is what? Null hypothesis, correct? Step 1 is what? Null hypothesis. Write the 5 steps. First one, null hypothesis. What is null hypothesis? H naught is what? He says mu is equal to 38. Correct? Then alternative hypothesis H1 is what? Mu is not equal to 38. Mu is not equal to 38 means what? It is a two-tailed test. He is asking at 95% level. So level of significance alpha, how much we have to take? 5% we have to take. Level of significance alpha is 5%. Now step 4. What is our step 4? Test statistic, z is equal to, what is the formula? X bar minus mu by sigma by root n. Test statistic, z is equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. Substitute the values. What is x bar I got? I got x bar, what is our x bar? Sample mean is 40, mu is equal to 38, sigma is how much? 10 by n is what? 400. So, 2 square root of 400 is how much? 20. This will go to numerator. 40 minus 38, 2, 2, 2 is a 40 by 10. I am getting 4. How much I am getting? I am getting 4. Now, what we have to write? We have to write conclusion. What is your conclusion? Step 5. Conclusion. Step 5. What is your step 5? Table Z. At alpha is equal to 5% level of significance is, for two-tailed test, table value is how much? 1.96. I will share this table in the group. Table Z is how much? Table Z at alpha is equal to 5% level of significance is how much? 1.96. So therefore, what is our calculated Z? Calculated Z we got 4. Then table Z we got 1.96. Therefore, Calculated Z is greater than table Z. Therefore, calculated Z is greater than table Z. If calculated Z is greater than table Z, what we have to do, you need to reject the null hypothesis. Therefore, reject H naught. What is H naught? We took it as H is equal to mu is equal to 38. That means the sample is not from the same population. Otherwise, the sample is not from the population whose mean is 38. So therefore, the sample is not from the population whose mean is 38. The sample is not from the population whose mean is 38. Like that, you need to solve this problem. Understand this problem? What we have to do, first of all, whatever the given data is there, that you need to take it as null hypothesis. What he's doing here? He's telling here, he collected one sample of 400 items. He took sample of 400 items from a population whose sample mean is 48 and population mean is what? 38. And he is asking, test whether this sample is collected from this population or not. Correct? To solve this, what we have to do? First of all, you need to write the given data. What is sample size? Sample size n is 400 items. Sample mean x bar is equal to how much? 40. Then deviation, standard deviation is how much? Sigma 10. Then population mean is what? Mu is equal to 38. Then to test the hypothesis, what we have to write? First of all, null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? Whatever the given information is there, that you take it as null hypothesis H naught. H naught is what? Mu is equal to 38. H naught, mu is equal to 38. Then alternative hypothesis H1 is what? Mu is not equal to 38. Opposite you need to take. Mu is not equal to 38. Then level of significance alpha, how much here? Alpha, he says 95%, no? So 5%. He will give you all the problems. If he didn't mention, then take it as 5% as level of significance. Level of significance alpha is how much? 5%. Now test statistic Z is equal. What is our formula? X bar minus mu by sigma by root n. X bar is 40, mu is 38, sigma is 10, n is what? 400. So root 400. Root 400 is 20. So this 2 will go to numerator. 40 minus 38, 2. 2 to the 4. 2 to the 4 into 0, 10, 20, 40 will come. Root 400 is 20, 20 to 2, 40, 40 by 10 is 4. Now you need to write step 5. Step 5 is what? Conclusion. Table Z at alpha, 5% level of significance is how much? 1.96. Now calculated Z is greater than, calculated Z we got 4. Then table Z is what? 1.96. So therefore calculated Z is greater than table Z. So what we have to do? You need to reject H naught. So therefore the sample is not from the population whose mean is 38. Now what is asking? He's asking confidence interval, right? So how to solve confidence interval? See here, confidence interval formula. Confidence interval formula, x bar minus table Z by table Z. Table Z, how much we got? 1.96 into sigma by root n, comma x bar plus 1.96 into sigma by root n. This is the confidence interval formula. X bar minus 1.96 into sigma by root n, comma x bar plus 1.96 into sigma by root n. What is our x bar? X bar we got 40 minus 1.96. What is our sigma value? Sigma value is what? Standard deviation 10 by square root of 400, comma x bar is how much? 40 plus 1.96 into 10 by square root of 400. So therefore, using calculator, this value I got by 2, no? I got 39.02 is one value, another value 40.98. This is the confidence interval. Very, very important. He will ask you confidence interval also. Okay, understand this problem, how to solve testing of hypothesis for single mean. Okay, so first of all, you have to write the full data. Then calculate test statistic, check whether with the table value. If table value is greater than is calculated value, then accept. If table value is less than, otherwise if calculated value is greater than table value, then reject the null hypothesis. Okay, so we'll go for another problem. Now see the second problem, what he's saying here. In a sample of 60 workers, the average time taken by them to get to work is 33.8 minutes with a standard deviation of 6.1 minute, right? And what is asking? Can we reject the null hypothesis mu is equal to 32.6 minutes in favor of alternative hypothesis mu is greater than 32.6 at alpha 1% level of significance? He gave mu null hypothesis as well as alternative hypothesis in the problem itself, correct? So what he is asking here, he sample of 60 workers, how much time they are taking? 33.8. but actually what is the population mean says 32.6 minutes, correct? But the difference is there, no? So he is asking whether can we reject this null hypothesis in favor of alternative hypothesis mu is greater than 32.6 or not. To check, he is asking, correct? So what we have to do, first of all, write down the given data. So what is given data here? Solution, sample size. Sample size, what is our n value? How many workers here? N is equal to 60, correct? Then sample mean. Sample mean x bar is how much, ma? 33.8 minutes. Then standard deviation, how much? Standard deviation sigma is how much? 6.1 minute. Then population mean mu is equal to 32.6 minutes, correct? Population mean is what? 32.6 minutes. Now, what we have to do, level of significance he gave, that we will write in that our 5 steps. So, what we have to do, that first one, null hypothesis you have to write, correct? What is our null hypothesis? Null hypothesis H naught. First point, null hypothesis. Write full, don't write N dot H, write full. Null hypothesis H naught is equal to how much, ma? H naught, he says, 32, H naught, null hypothesis H naught. Mu is equal to 32.6. Mu is equal to how much? 32.6. Now, alternative hypothesis H1. Alternative hypothesis denoted by the symbol H1. Alternative hypothesis H1 is how much? He says mu is greater than 32.6. Mu is greater than 32.6. That is what this is. Which tail test it is? It is right tail test. Then level of significance alpha. Level of significance alpha, how much he gave here? He gave 1%, that means 0.01. 1% is how much? 1 by 100? No, so 0.01. now test statistic, test statistic z is equal to, what is the formula? X bar minus mu by sigma by root n. You got all the values, no? You got all the values, right? So substitute x bar. What is our x bar? X bar is 33.8 minus mu. What is our mu value? 32.6 by sigma. What is our sigma? 6.1 by square root of n. N is how much? 60. N is how much? 60. Then take the calculator. 1 second. Okay. So using calculator, I got the value. This one is 1.52. I got 1.52. How much I got, ma? I got 1.52. Now what we have to do, you have to write step 5. What is your step 5? Table z at alpha is equal to 1%, level of significance is, table value at alpha 1% level of significance is 2.58. how much, ma? It is 2.58. It is, these all table values are there. Otherwise, I will post in the group. This table value is very, very important. Sometimes he will give you this table value in the problem. Otherwise, you need to take this Xerox copy in the exam hall. Okay. So table Z at alpha is equal to 1% level of significance is how much? 2.58. So what is calculated value we got? Calculated value we got 1.52. But table value is how much? 2.58. So therefore, calculated z is less than calculated less is less calculated z is less than table z calculated z is calculated z is less than table z. So if calculated z is less than table z, so what we have to do, ma? What we have to do? You need to accept the null hypothesis. So therefore, accept H naught. That means this sample is collected from the population whose mean is what? 32.6. But by mistake it has happened. What happened? Somebody is delayed. They got mean is what? 33.8. Okay. So therefore, the null hypothesis H naught is accepted. So like this, you need to solve these all problems, ma. Understand? It's very, very important. Testing or test of hypothesis. We have total how many? We have four types in this unit 4. The first part we already completed. The second part, the test of significance, may we have four types. First one is test of significance for single mean is there. Test of significance for difference of mean is there. And then test of significance for difference of standard deviations is there. Then single proportion and difference of proportions. These all four types are there. This difference of standard deviations will come in that same difference of means itself. So total we have four methods. From the four methods we get one problem for long answer. Very, very important. This topic, test of significance, is very, very important. This is for large samples, and unit 5 is related to this. Unit 5 is test of significance for small sample, it is. Okay, that is for small sample, and this is for large sample. Okay, see the another problem. What is telling here? A sample of 40 diesel engines produced by a company. A sample of 40 diesel engines produced by a company show that they have a mean thermal efficiency. They have a mean thermal efficiency of 31.45% with a standard deviation of 1.6%. Then what is asking? He's asking, test at population mean mu is equal to 32.3% at 1% level of significance. At 1% level of significance, he's asking. Okay. So how to solve this problem? See here, first of all, same solution. So first, write down the given data, sample size. See, I am writing for each and every problem. You also write this all data, each and every problem, and maintain the notes. These problems are all very, very important problems. Sample size. N is equal to how much sample size? N is equal to how many? 40. Then sample mean x bar is how much? It is 31.45. Then standard deviation sigma is how much? 1.6%. Then population mean mu is equal to 32.3. okay, 32.3. this is the given data. Now what we have to do? We have to write these five steps. What are the five steps? First one is what? Null hypothesis H naught. What is null hypothesis H naught? Mu, he says 32.3. Alternative hypothesis H1, mu is what? Not equal to 32.3. Then level of significance alpha is how much here? Level of significance alpha, how much he says? 1%, that means 0.01. Now test statistic, z is equal to, what is the formula? X bar minus mu by sigma by root n. X bar minus mu by sigma by root n. Substitute the values, ma. What is our x bar? X bar is 31.45 minus mu. What is the mu value? 32.3 by sigma. What is the sigma? 1.6 by square root of 40. Take the calculator and solve it. Okay, this value is coming in negative. So minus 3.33 I got. Minus 3.33. So when we get minus, so what we have to do? You need to write in the mod. Take mod z. Mod is what? Mod 3.33 will give you positive value. 3.33 will give you positive value, right? 3.33. Now what is the fifth point? Table z. So table z at alpha is equal to 1% level of significance is how much, ma? 2.58. Correct. Table Z is how much? 2.58, no? So therefore, 2.58. So therefore, calculated Z is greater than table Z. Calculated Z is greater than table Z. Why? Because calculated Z, how much we got? We got 3.33. The table Z at 1% level of significance is how much? 2.58. Just now we solved for previous problem, no? 2.58. So therefore, what we have to do? Reject H naught. That's it. So you need to reject. Calculated Z is greater than, calculated Z is greater than table Z. You need to reject H naught. That means mu cannot be 32.3. It can be more than 32.3 or it can be less than 32.3. That means alternative hypothesis H1 is accepted. Like this, you need to solve these problems. Understand these problems? These all are similar problems. Only thing is whatever the given data is there, that you need to write it in the stepwise in correct manner. The sample size always n, sample mean is what, x bar. So many students in hurry, population mean they will write it as sample mean. So that means they will change, interchange. Only the thing is what, answer will come in the negative way, no problem. But here the data will change, that is the problem, right? So population mean always denoted by mu, sample mean is always denoted by x bar. So take, write down the all the data and substitute in the formula test statistic z, x bar minus mu by sigma by root n, and calculate the value and write down the, find the table value, check whether the table value is greater than or not. If calculated value is greater than table value, then reject H naught. If calculated value is less than table value, then accept null hypothesis. Okay. See the next problem, what is saying here. A sample of 100 iron bars are drawn from a population whose mean is 4 feet, and standard deviation is how much, 0.6 feet. And what is asking? If the sample mean is 4.2 feet, can the sample be regarded as a, truly random sample? Can the sample be regarded as a truly random sample or not? He's asking. Correct. So first, what we have to do, take down the given data, whatever the data is gave here. What he gave here, sample size n is equal to how many, 100, then sample mean x bar, how much it is, 4.2, which is what, sample size. Then standard deviation sigma is how much, 0.6. Then population mean mu, how much he says 4 feet. Correct. So substitute level of significance. Did he mention level of significance here? No, he didn't mention level of significance. Whenever the level of significance is not mentioned, so what we have to do, you need to take it as 5% level of significance. Whenever, if level of significance is not mentioned in the problem, consider as alpha is 5%. Okay. So right on the first step, null hypothesis H naught. What is our null hypothesis H naught? It is what? How much it is? 4 feet, right? Mu is equal to 4 feet, right? Then alternative hypothesis H1, what? The sample cannot be, we'll change this level of significance here. What he's asking in the problem? He's asking, can the sample be regarded as a truly random sample? He's asking, right? So null hypothesis I am assuming as, sample can be regarded as a truly random sample. So I am taking this one is as, sample can be regarded as a truly random sample. Now alternative hypothesis H1, what you have to write, the sample cannot be regarded as a random sample. It cannot be regarded as a random example. Okay, so I changed here, little bit change. He's asking, no, now level of significance alpha, level of significance alpha, he didn't mention here, so take it as 5%, that means 0.05. level of significance alpha, he didn't mention here, that's what, how much we took it, we took it as 5%, right? Now what you need to do, test statistic Z, fourth step. What is the fourth step? Test statistic. Test statistic Z is equal, what is the formula, ma? X bar minus mu by sigma by root n, right? So there, so therefore, what is our X bar value? 4.2 minus, what is our mu value? 4. Sigma is how much, ma? 0.6 by square root of 100. So that means it will 10, 2 by 0.6. So 2 by 0.6 means 20 by 6, 3.33 will come, it is 3.33. How much it came? 3.33. Now, what we have to do, you need to calculate conclusion. So now, table Z at alpha is equal to 5% level of significance is, table Z at alpha, 5% level of significance is how much, ma? 1.96. So therefore, calculated Z is greater than table Z. Calculated Z is how much? Greater than. So calculated we got 3.3. Table Z how much it is? 1.96. So therefore, calculated Z is greater than table Z. If calculated Z is greater than table Z, so what we have to do? You need to reject the null hypothesis. So therefore, reject H naught. Reject the null hypothesis. That means sample cannot be regarded as a truly random. Sample can be regarded as a truly random sample, cannot be accepted. So what you have to accept here? You need to accept alternative hypothesis. That means sample cannot be regarded as a random sample. Sample cannot be regarded as a random sample. So like this, you need to solve these all problems. Okay, so these all are very, very important problems, ma. These all are previous year question paper problems. So we started test of significance in previous class. So test of significance previous class with a single mean sums we are solving. Okay, we completed test of significance single mean problems. Okay, I will send you that another video also. So in that video also you have so many problems. So practice those all problems. Maintain the notes. So listening the class and writing the class, there is a lot of writing the notes, there is a lot of differences there. When you start writing these all problems, no, so you'll practice this, you'll get automatically practice, and you'll get the all doubts and all, so then you can ask me, clear? If you won't write the notes and all, then at the time of exam, it is very difficult to solve these all problems in the exam, okay? So try to maintain the notes. Once the college is open, so I'll check the notes, okay? Be ready with that. So try to day to day, whatever the problems are explained in everyday class, so try to solve those all problems in the notes, so that you will become perfect in this topic, okay? So we'll meet tomorrow in the next class, so with the topic a test of significance for difference of means. So this is what single mean we solved, then we have difference of means, okay? So in today's class I explain about confidence interval also. So confidence interval also very, very important. He will ask you, if the problem is for a long answer, then he will ask you along with this problem, he will ask you confidence interval also. Construct the confidence interval to the given data also he will ask, okay? So you learn that formula also, write down that formula also, confidence interval formula. We will meet in the next class, okay? I explained today total 4 problems, and I will send you one more video of 4 problems. So practice those problems. In last class I explained one more problem. So total 9 problems are there. So 9 different models are there. So most probably you will get the problem in the same data. But only thing is what? Numbers will be changed. Understand? If you know how to write, if you know the information, whatever the information is given in the problem, then it is very easy to solve these all problems, ma. Okay? So we'll meet in the next class. Thank you.